proclamation recognizing Austin Parrish. Whereas on October 7th, 2022, Taylor High School 12th grade student Austin Parrish raced to the aid of a fellow classmate suffering a seizure. And whereas Austin Parrish enrolled in the Fire Public Safety AMS program, utilized his training, and immediately put 10th grade student Caden Button on his left side. And whereas those first few minutes of a seizure are critical, and because of Austin's quick response, Lutton's life was saved. Now, therefore, be it proclaimed that the Taylor City Council, together with all the elected officials of the City of Taylor, do hereby proclaim that Austin Parrish be recognized for his heroic actions that saved Caden Lutton's life. Mr. Parrish, thank you. And if you would like to say a few words, and I'm not certain if we have Mr. Lutton here this evening. If not, you have the floor.
I just want to say thank you. And I want to thank my family for pushing me along and believing in me and every step that I've gone through my life. And I also want to thank this tomorrow, my teacher. If he was one of our teachers today, I don't know how to do how to help somebody in that situation. I want to thank him and another person for teaching.
Please don't go away. We're going to take a vote and then I can present the proclamation to you, but you are a fine example of why the skilled trades and career and technical education are important in our city and in our community and within the state. So we have a motion by Councilwoman Witten, supported by Councilman Slavin. All those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All those opposed say no. The yeses have it. Motion carried. We will momentarily while I present this. That brings us to the next item on the agenda, 6.3, which is a motion to approve letter of agreement between the City of Taylor and ASME Michigan Council 25, Local 11.8.
Make a motion.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Johnson, supported by Councilwoman Ray Dana. Is there any discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All those opposed say no. The yeses have it, motion carried. That brings us to the regular agenda. Item 7.1 is a motion to approve the first reading of case number 22-21Z, the southerly approximately 197 feet of parcel number 60-052-99-0026-000 of the southeast one quarter section 19, town 3 south, route 10 east, City of Taylor, Wayne County, Michigan, to be rezoned from I-1 Light Industrial to B-3 General Business. The property is located on the north side of North Line, just west of Beach Daily Road. Motion by Councilman Johnson. I believe that was supported by Councilman Slavin. Is there any discussion? For the public's, we did talk about this last night, for the public's knowledge, this is the property due north of Dominic's. sign that says it's about to be rezoned. I've got myself turned around. So just wanted to clarify that some questions have come up. When we do these rezoning, we talk about the very technical aspects of the property numbers. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All those opposed say no. The yeses have it, motion carried. Item 7.2 is a motion to approve the first reading of an ordinance titled Marijuana Commercial Businesses.
Motion to postpone to 12/6.
There's a motion to postpone to a time certain of 12/6. Motion to postpone to December 6, 2022, the first reading of an ordinance titled Marijuana Commercial Business. That was a motion by Councilwoman Gray-Nana. I believe that was supported by Councilman Sleeman. Is there any discussion? Councilwoman Witt.
I believe we're going to, we have drafts and we are going to submit our suggestions. I know I have some notes that I didn't send you last night. I will send all of mine out. Is that what should be the process? If people have input, should they send it to all councils? Should they send it to court council?
Mr. Plato, if you could go through the timeline that we had discussed, so that there's the proper amount of time that he can take in the input and then provide a final copy to the council in the next study packet.
Can I make, before he does that, one other comment? I believe we had discussed this getting, it needs to get referred to planning. So I know we need a proposed draft to go there, but if we can't really do a first reading on 12/6, then I would think it would be 12/20, maybe. I'm not sure.
In talking with at least the corporation council and listening to the council last night, the process or at least time frame that would facilitate us having a good draft or at least a good preliminary draft that could be a first reading would be that and to have that complete around November 30th or December 1st, so that it can be placed upon the agenda, would be to give the Corporation Council input by November 23rd, next Wednesday. So all input from the council would go to the Corporation Council. That way, it is not any 4, 5, or 6 of us trying to figure it out. That will then give him, not quite a week, it'd be a week, 7 or 8 days, but there's Thanksgiving in there, and I would think. I will leave it to Mr. Plato to confirm if that would work.
Yes, thank you, Chairman. I would add that all the council could get their comments to me, any input by November 23rd, and I will give you what I hope to be a final draft subject to minor modifications. November 30th or December 1st. That way you'll have until the meeting on the 6th to review it. If there's any final comments or changes that need to be made, then you can address those to me in between when you get the final draft and the meeting on December 6th. And then you can break those also.
Councilman Slavin and then Councilman Johnson.
Going forward on the